totally new and exciting place. Gotta get out of the tent sometimes. Today, I'm on the coast of California, and I've always loved the beach and the ocean, and I just can't wait to start exploring. I wish I could spend the whole day here.
Yeah, I wish I could too.
Cheers!
Hey, Cammy! Welcome to Monterey Bay! I'm so glad you're here!
I'm glad I'm here too!
Well, you're in one of my most favorite places in the whole world. And I would love to take you out tide pooling. Wanna go?
Let's go!
All right, let's go find some animals.
Woo! Tide pools are so cool. Can you tell me more about them?
Well, yeah. I mean, this is where the land meets the sea. And every day the tide goes out and in twice a day. And when it goes out, it exposes all this life that's normally under the water. So we can get a peek inside what's going on in the ocean at low tide, which is what it is right now. So if we can go out, the ocean, when the tide goes out, it leaves behind these little pools of life. And there are so many critters in there. It looks peaceful, but oh, it's predator prey every day out here in the tide pools.
That's awesome.
Want to go check out some?
Let's
some
go.
Okay, so let's check out some critters here. Now this just looks like sand on rock. This is covered with anemones. All these are clonal anemones. That means they're genetically identical. And look, if you put your finger in, you'll see them move.
So does this mean if...
Whoop!
Oh, does this mean that it starts out with one and it multiplies into another until it looks like all of this?
Until it turns into a total carpet. Look, every single part of this place is covered with anemones. Look at them. And if I push on them... Isn't that cool?
That's so cool.
That's how they protect themselves. And this is a little piece of beautiful giant kelp. Isn't that beautiful?
It's beautiful.
That's actually what makes up the logo of the Monterey Bay Aquarium.
Oh.
Isn't that so pretty?
We're lucky we found it.
Well, this is a defining feature of Monterey Bay, are the kelp forests made a lot from Macrocystis. And they have these little floats, they call them mermaid bladders. And what's important about the mermaid bladders is that the kelp, as it grows, it needs to get these fronds up to the sunlight so it can grow fast. And these guys can grow up to 2 feet in one day. Isn't that amazing? Even more. They can get to be, you know, 40, 50, 60, 100 feet long. They're an annual, so they grow during a long summer days, and then the storms rip them out and they have to start all over again. But the kelp forests create incredible habitats for hundreds and hundreds of species, especially things like sea otters, who love to wrap themselves up in the kelp and take a nap so they don't get washed away. And then after they're wrapped up in their little bed of kelp, then they'll go down and look for things like that abalone we were just looking at. But they're beautiful too, aren't they?
They are.
But they make up these golden floating forests that are home to hundreds and hundreds of critters. Without the kelp, Monterey Bay just wouldn't be Monterey Bay. All right, let's go find some more critters.
Let's go.
Oh, so Cammy, I wanted to bring you here to the commercial wharf at Monterey because I got a special guest I want to introduce you to.
I love special
guests.
Are you
excited?
I'm so excited.
Okay, so here goes. This is a red octopus. I'm going to pull him out. Just a second. I'll pull him out.
Oh.
He's pretty shy. Oh, their arms are covered with suckers, and that's how they get along. They move along. Yep. Oh, he's really...
He really does not like being out here.
Well, he's just really crawling around. Do you want to touch him?
Yeah.
This is
That's amazing.
Red octopus. Maybe we can get him back here.
Yeah, okay. This has been so much fun. Thanks for visiting me today and exploring with me.
Oh, well, come visit me anytime.
For more fun ideas, visit animaljam.com and don't forget to...